This session's outline is constructivist theories of learning. At the end of this session, you will be able to discuss the constructivist theories of learning. Students, we say cognitivist theories are also constructivist theories. Since mind is involved in learning, each one's mind will process a particular information in the light of one's own previous experiences. In other words, when one tries to learn by processing information, by using thinking, reasoning, then in the light of one's previous experiences, one perceives that particular situation and interprets that particular situation. In this way, if one has to learn, the learner has to be engaged in the learning process actively, perceiving, conceptualizing, generalizing. So, with every encounter with a learning situation, the mental model of each student will be constructed, which will be different from that of the other student, because the previous experiences of the students in relation to that particular situation might be different. So, these constructivist theories focus on the role of the learner as an active learner and the role of the teacher as a facilitator whose job is to engage the learner actively to interact with the learning situation so as to result in achievement of learning objectives. We use cognitivist and constructivist theories together in the sense that mind is involved in learning and the mental processes like thinking, analyzing, synthesizing, reasoning are all involved this kind of learning. The only difference being the constructivist theories project the learner as not absorbing certain things told by the teacher as they are, but trying to interpret that information given by the teacher or the books or the other sources in the light of one's own previous experiences. In a class of 40, if the teacher is explaining certain things, each person will construct his own understanding of that particular information in the light of one's previous experiences. Therefore, learning is not a spectator sport. You cannot just sit, watch, and learn. Learning will bring in changes in your mental models, and each one's construction of knowledge will be different from that of the other. Therefore, to see that teaching results in learning, the teacher cannot go on teaching in a one-way process, as it may not necessarily result in learning. To see that teaching results in learning, the learners ought to be engaged in the learning process. They have to interact with the learning situation. For example, if the teacher is explaining about friction, wants to develop the concept of friction in the minds of the students, it is not enough to show some examples. The teacher has just to be a facilitator and should organize such activities in which the children engage themselves by moving things or even walking on smooth surfaces and the rough surfaces, moving balls and objects on different kinds of surfaces and realizing how it is on a smooth surface, how it is on a rough surface, whether it helps in or hinders movement, whether friction is good or bad, writing on a board which is smooth and oily and writing on a board which is rough, and realizing some amount of friction is necessary for writing, for walking, for running and all that. That will result in a better concept of friction than the teacher giving her own examples about friction. Thus, the teacher's role in such a situation becomes that of a facilitator. The teacher cannot preach certain things, expecting children to rote memorize them. The teacher has to facilitate learning by organizing various learning activities, which should result in specific learning. I would like to give another example. If in geography, we are to understand which are the countries through which the imaginary lines of equator, Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn go, there is no other way to teach but to make the students hold the atlas in their hands and identify those lines and also find out through which countries the lines cross. Similarly, if a child has to know the latitude and the longitude of a place, the child has to actually look into the atlas or a map and measure the different latitudes and longitudes, then only the learning will happen. Otherwise, it will be only little facts which are just memorized by the students blindly. Such implications are the results of the theories, same cognitive theories propounded by Jean Piaget, David Ausubel and Jerome Bruner. Only thing is, the mode in which such learning happens is by active engagement of the learner who interacts with the learning situation, which results in certain awareness and understanding, because of which that knowledge becomes useful in daily life also. Thus, we saw that the cognitivist theories are also constructivist theories. Learning is essentially the result of active engagement of the learner with the learning situation, and learning enables each learner to construct one's own mental models in the light of one's previous experiences. Therefore, the role of the teacher becomes that of a facilitator whose job is to organize meaningful activities that can engage the learner in the learning process so as to achieve the learning objectives. The theories of cognitivist theories of learning, that of Piaget, Ausubel and Bruner, are also constructivist theories in this sense. Thank you.